Mississippi Bridge.
Bakersfield sound. Look at this. I mean, is this synchronicity or what? I have a letter in front of me. Hello, Ian and Terry. Greetings from Memphis, Tennessee. I mean, what are the chances? What are the chances of that? Eh, Francis? I mean, it's amazing. I mean, we play a song about Memphis. Anyway, greetings from Memphis, Tennessee. This is Chris Freitas, who has now finished his journalism degree at the University of Memphis. I am saddened to hear that Radio Canada International is shutting down in shortwave and satellite services. Does this also mean that the station will end its streaming audio and podcast services as well? You got it, Chris. Recently, several broadcasters have left or are in the process of leaving the traditional radio business for good. Recently, Radio Netherlands Worldwide has decided to terminate all English broadcasts, including its online services. Do the powers that be realize that they are silencing the only voice to the rest of the world? I love internet radio as much as shortwave, but there are still many people worldwide that lack web access or even a computer. It seems very silly that those in charge of these stations, including RCI, would rather save a buck than lose their audience than stay on the air. Regardless, I have enjoyed listening to RCI since I first began listening to shortwave in 1997.
Well, I remember Chris.
On a Sears multiband radio. After reading an article in Boys Life magazine, Canada was one of my many voices I heard on the HF. If I recall, the frequency was 9740 kHz. Anywho, I really enjoyed tuning into the Mapleleaf Mailbag, especially when both of you guys were running the show. I realized that Ian has been the host since I have been a shortwave listener. The past 15 years have been eventful, to say the least. Should RCI end its web service, I can still listen to CBC for all things Canada. But RCI will be missed dearly. After all, it was one of my first stations I ever listened to on shortwave. I am sad to see many great broadcasters are leaving the medium. Thankfully, most of them are online, and I can still listen to those voices. But it's not quite the same thing as tuning in on a portable radio that doesn't require a web connection. Internet radio doesn't hold the joy of trying to find distant signals thousands of miles away from the point of voice. Certainly told me that RCI, I will remember the fond time tuning in and listening to great stories of the world and my home. It's been a friend that is always welcome. I wish everyone at RCI success in finding new employment and future endeavors. I also wish fellow listeners to be not discouraged about these developments in the HF band. Give internet radio a chance. But many are content really matters, not how it is being broadcast per se. Well, Chris, I love you, man, but I don't agree with you about that. It's not just content, but why are you so... Maybe it's people my age. Broadcasters are responsible for my greater awareness of world events.